ಗಿರಿನಂದಿನಿ ನಂದಿತ ಮೇದಿನಿ ವಿಶ್ವ ವಿನೋದಿನಿ ಭವತಿ ಹೇಷಿತಿ ಕಂಠ ಕುಟುಂಬಿನಿ ಭೂರಿ ಕುಟುಂಬಿನಿ ಭೂರಿ ಕೃತೆ ಜಯ ಜಯ ಹೇ ಮಹಿಷಾಸುರ ಮರ್ದಿನಿ ರಮ್ಯ ಕಪರ್ದಿನಿ ಶೈಲಸುತೆ.
ಗುರು ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ, ಗುರು ವಿಷ್ಣು, ಗುರು ದೇವೋ ಮಹೇಶ್ವರ. ಹಿಯರ್ ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್. ಗುರು ಸಾಕ್ಷಾತ್ ಪರಬ್ರಹ್ಮ, ತಸ್ಮೈ ಶ್ರೀ ಗುರುವೇ ನಮಃ. ಗುರು ಈಸ್ ಅ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟರ್, ಗುರು ಈಸ್ ದಿ ಸಸ್ಟೈನರ್, ಗುರು ಈಸ್ ದಿ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಾಯರ್. ಬಟ್ ಅಲ್ಟಿಮೇಟ್ಲಿ ಹೂ ಈಸ್ ದಿ ರಿಯಲ್ ಗುರು? ಸಾಕ್ಷಾತ್ ಪರಬ್ರಹ್ಮ. ಫಾರ್ ದಟ್ ಗುರು ತಸ್ಮೈ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಐ ಆಫರ್ ಮೈ ಗ್ರಾಟಿಟ್ಯೂಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಲವ್. ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪರಬ್ರಹ್ಮ ಈಸ್ ದ ರಿಯಲ್ ಗುರು. This Parama Tattva is the real Guru. That we need to understand who is real Guru. And this Parama Tattva is guiding all of us through different human bodies, through different objects in our life. Maybe sometimes you may learn something from a tree, something you learn from your friend, something you learn from your own family member, something you learn from some book. But it is a principle that is guiding you through different objects, through different peoples in your life. So I told you, you know, we meditated, we offer our gratitude to all masters. Somehow they have helped us to reach one step, to reach one more step, to reach one more step towards self-realization, towards God realize. So real Guru is Parama Tattva, you know, or Parabrahma, that, you know, consciousness, the truth consciousness, soul consciousness, or divine consciousness. That is a real Guru. First, this should be our understanding, that who is real. So we call Divine Mother Lalitambika Rajarajeshu Mahatripura Sundari is Dakshinamurti Rupini. Means from Dakshinamurti, that guiding principle is flowing to the rishis. You see that? We are not just worshipping Dakshinamurti, we go beyond that to see who is the background. That is Lalitambika, Rajaraj, Mahatipur. So, she is the one who is the Paramatattva, who is the real guru of all gurus, who is a real master of all Siddhas, Yogis and Rishis. That Mahatripura Sundari. A oneness. It is a form of oneness of Shiva and Shakti. It is not Shakti, it is not a Shiva. It is a oneness of Shiva and Shakti. That is the real Guru principle. That Parama Tattva, that a Parama or Parabrahma Swarupini. We can call with different names, but that principle is guiding. In Lalita Sahasram, again it is said, Guru Mandala Rupini. You see that? If I have a Guru Mandala of masters, of Siddhas in a Siddha Loka, or Rishis in a Rishis, or any other different dimension, that Mandala, that collective consciousness of the masters, where the energy, the teaching principle is there, that is nothing but Divine Mother Lalitambika Raja Rajeshwari Mahatripura. So we pray today, Jagan Mata, you come as our master and guide us, lift us, help us. Because she is a true master. She is a true master who is teaching through different Siddhas, who is teaching through different yoginis, who is teaching through different books, through different techniques, through different mantras, through different experiences. So real Guru is that, you know, unconditional love, compassionate Divine Mother Lalitambika Rajaraj Mahatripura. So that ultimate source is the real Guru. But here the problem will come to understand the Parama Tattva. If I tell you that principle is the Parama, means your mind cannot understand. Your mind cannot understand. Because your mind don't know who you are, first of all. You are a spark of Shivayan Shakti. Every scripture says, every Upanishad says, every Veda says that you are temple of Shiva Shakti. You are a spark of Shiva Shakti. You are a spiritual spark of Shiva Shakti or the divine consciousness or truth consciousness. Or the nature of you is Satchitanand. But the problem is our senses cannot understand. Our mind cannot understand. Our intellectual ability cannot understand who am I. That soul, that Chaitanya cannot be understood. So, the real Guru is within you as a soul. Real Guru is within you as a soul, Chaitanya, Parabrahma Swarupa. But our mind cannot understand. Our senses cannot understand. So, this is the true inner Guru. This is the true inner Guru. To reach this inner Guru, you need an external Guru. Got this point? I cannot see with my own eyes that I have a Guru already within me. That spark of Shiva Shakti is already there. That guiding principle is already there in me. But with my mind, intellectual ability, I cannot experience, I cannot understand, I cannot accept it. This is very, very important and very challenging, that to accept that there is a Guru principle that is working within you already. So you need an outer Guru. You need an outer Guru. One more person who has to teach you, who has to guide you, to take you to your inner. So that is the job of the outside master, who will take you to your real Guru. To your real Guru, I am telling again. So outside masters are reflection of inner master. You see that? Outer masters, whatever, whomever you are learning from, whatever master, he is helping you to go to one step ahead towards your path. To self, to discover the truth about yourself. That's what we, I have given the quoting. Discover the Divine Mother within you. Sri Vidya Sadhana, discover the Divine Mother within you, not outside. Because she is living you as you. Only she is going to manifest her own ultimate truth consciousness as you progress with your sadhana. Step by step, she will progress. So first we understand who is a real Guru. Then we understand what is inner Guru. What is inner Guru? Then we understand who is outer Guru and how he can help to us. Is it clear to you? So this is very important to have understand. Now outer Guru is there. Again, there is a qualification and there is, you know, steps for the outer Guru. There is a differentiation. Guru is there. Okay, Sadguru is there, Siddha Guru is there. Guru is there, Sadguru is there, Siddha Guru is there. So Guru is the one who experienced the truth, who experienced the inner Guru and know that inner Guru and try to manifest it outside through his words, through his expression, through his actions. The person who just understand the inner Guru, that his soul, the truth consciousness, the Satchidananda Swarupa is a real Guru, real master, real Siddha within him. After understanding, he guides outside person to reach inner Guru. So we call him as a Guru outside. But again, one more stage, higher stage, we called Sat Guru. Sat means the truth, Guru. Who experiences himself as a truth consciousness, plus who expresses that truth consciousness outside through his words, through his power, through his actions. First is just realization. Second is expression of that realization through his personality. So we call self-realized master. Self means not body, not mind, but the soul, the truth. So that we called Sadguru. Sadguru, who experienced the truth, experienced the real Guru, who experienced the Shiva Shakti, who don't have any differences, whose I consciousness become that. He is the Sadguru, a self-realized master. Now, we go one more step. Guru, Sadguru, Siddha Guru. You see that? Sadguru Tirumular. Our Siddha, our real master. What it means? A person who experienced the truth, Paramatattva, expressing that Paramatattva, truth, through his words, through his action, through his soul power, initiating people, seeding this truth consciousness into another student, soul, awakening another student, other people. Awakening Paramatattva in their soul through Diksha, through Upadesha. That is the Sadguru. But Siddha goes one step ahead. Siddha goes one step ahead, and not only he expresses this Paramatattva through his words, through his actions, but brings that Paramatattva, that truth consciousness, at the physical cell level. This is very important. Where he transforms his physical body into a golden light body. He is not just immortal with his consciousness. He is immortal at the physical level. So we call him as a perfect Siddha. Until you have this physical body, still imperfection, limitation is there. The moment I transfer this body into golden light of unconditional love, golden light of truth consciousness or Paramatattva, that Sharira, immortal body, then that master is called as a Siddha master. This is very important to understand. Who is a real Guru? Who is an inner Guru? Who is outer Guru? And what type of Gurus and what they can have a power to give to you? Just a Guru help you with Upadesha. Upadesha. Desha means place. Upa means near to the place. Upadesha means to bring you near to the place. What is the place you want to go near? To Shiva Shakti. To Shiva Shakti. To truth. Experience the truth. So that is what we called Guru gives the Upadesha. What he does? He brings you nearer to Shiva Shakti. Nearer to Satchidananda. Nearer to truth consciousness. That is Upadesha. Guru can give. So you see that many masters give the mantra and ask you to do all the Purushacharana. It is Upadesha. It is a guidance to follow this path that will lead you nearer to the truth. Upadesha. Then if you go for a self-realized master, Sadguru, he is not give a Upadesha, he give a Diksha. Upadesha is different, Diksha is different. Upadesha means guidance is given, but you have to earn from yourself with that technique, with that whatever you do. You have to do millions of japas. You have to do havana, tarpana, homa, purushachana, all of that. That is what Guru gives. But when you receive the diksha that is given by Sadguru, what he does? Sadguru seeds his truth consciousness in your soul. You see that? He charges your soul with that Paramatattva directly. You don't need to go with, you know, chanting the mantra to reach that. Directly, I seed the truth consciousness into your soul. All you have to do is remember, connect, and experience. So, that is a Sadguru, where he does that. Then if you go for higher level, Siddha, it is something very, very different. He directly gives a self-realization. This is what our, you know, Master Sadguru Tirumala. No mantra to chant. No, you know, form to worship. Just to connect and surrender. Connect and surrender. That is what Lord Krishna said in the last chapter, 18th chapter. He didn't say in the first chapter. Because he know that he is a Siddha. You know, that pure consciousness, Krishna. He said that, surrender to me, I give this to you. Same with Sadguru Tirumala. Surrender to me, I pass this to you. I am living. In a physical body, I am living with Paramatattva. You just invoke, I just flow into you. That is what we call Guru Mantra. Real Guru Mantra. That transform, bring this transformation from human to divine. Gives the experience of the formless. It's very important. Awaken your intuition to experience the truth. Awaken your intuition to experience the truth. So, we are blessed to connect with this master, Sadguru Tirumular. We need to feel this blessing. We need to offer our gratitude that, Master, I don't know, unknowingly, because of my karmas, I landed here. How blessed I am. How blessed I am.